You ain't doing nothing. Let's get you a look in here. See if we find any dirt. I ain't looking in those ports yet. Just in this valley. How's that hole? Just remind y'all, this has got 102,000 miles on it. Low mileage, low mileage, low mileage. So I got my little baby 2-gallon Stanley hooked up to my big wet dry vac. Looks like we'll clean. I stuffed the towels and all the coolant and intake ports. I ran this over with the wet dry vac. Also ran over these holes kind of like back and forth like this with the nozzle of the wet dry vac. It will pull up any dirt that's in there. These are gonna be clean. I'm going to be using a brake cleaner. Start off with this nylon, then go with the brass, and I really doubt I won't need the steel, but I need to be careful with that. You can also use a razor to do your cleaning. Alright, so this is the first pass with just the nylon brush. Color don't matter, it's just smoothness. It's So we're going to use the brass on it next. Get the end valleys afterwards. About used up this can, 13 ounces. Doing two passes, nylon brush and my brass brush. Yeah, it looks pretty clean now. Might want to hit this a little bit more for today. This is smooth. Yeah, I think I'm just going to hit this up. And we got some gasket sealing right there. Needs to be clean. Clean that up a little bit. Right here. We're back. Just scrub down with the steel brush. That's smooth enough for a gasket. That's a little bit dirty here. But this is a raised ridge. Smooth. Kind of iffy here. That needs some more cleaning. A little bit up on top. Smooth. This is good. Maybe a tad. Starting to getting around dust, and I think I'm done with this. Just don't like getting a steel brush on these heads. I've got everything cleaned up, EGR, upper intake manifold, lower. I've got my bolts and nuts cleaned up and baggied off. This is the intake after I've cleaned it. I sprayed some white grease onto a paper towel and I rubbed it just here, and I avoided this spot right here, so this is dry. I've cleaned this off with brake cleaner because the RTV won't seal. And you need to have about half inch here for RTV on all these corners. So these are bone dry right here. I vacuumed out all the ports and the coolant passages. And all these have been vacuumed out. Never rub silicone here, but this is bone dry. No silicone here because you want RTV to stick. That little corner has been cleaned off a brake cleaner, so there's no silicone grease on it, as well as this and this. I've also vacuumed out the valley and I've sprayed the valley down with brake cleaner. I'm going to use some leftover oil and pour that into the valley. I just wanted to make sure all the debris was flushed down into the oil galleys because I'm going to change the oil when I've got this put back together. Here's our new FelPro PermaDry gaskets. This is the RTV it comes with. Oh, it came with gray. I thought it came with black. We got new intake manifold bolts. And I've got on hand some ultra black in case that's not enough. But according to FelPro, you should use exactly this much. If you run out and you still need more, you probably use too much. Got a clean funnel so I can direct the oil onto the sides of the valley.